Nursing care plays a very important role for stroke patients' speedy recovery. Most patients have hemiparesis, difficulty in speech, and dysphagia. In this training video, we will be demonstrating the following specific areas in nursing care. Positioning the patient, prevention of pressure sores, prevention of infection, providing nutrition and hydration via NG tube. In addition to these, nursing care involves 24/7 care, involving close monitoring of vital parameters, medical management, coordination with multidisciplinary stroke team members, healthcare education, and providing emotional support for the patient and caregivers. Now let us discuss prevention of pressure sores. Pressure sores occur due to skin breakdown in patients with poor mobility and should always be prevented. We can do it by providing an air mattress, keeping the skin clean and dry, especially in the presence of urinary and fecal incontinence, properly positioning the patient, changing the position every 2 hours, check daily over the skin for red areas, especially in pressure points like elbows, heels, scapula, sacrum, and hip. Give pressure point care using an emollient according to 4 massage techniques. Effleurage. Friction, petrissage, and tap ointment. Encourage early mobilization and also providing good nutrition. Now, let us discuss prevention of infection. Infection is a primary post-stroke complication which can delay the patient's recovery. Here are some basic principles to follow always. Hand washing before and after approaching the patient. Ensure the cleanliness of the patient's environment and changing bed linen. Ensure sterility of invasive procedures and maintain cleanliness of the skin in relation to the invasive devices such as cannulas, urinary catheter, and the NG tube. IV catheters must be changed after 3 days and urinary catheters must be changed as medical advice. And ensure good oral hygiene with regular mouth care. Follow infection protocol and guidelines. Finally, let us discuss the NG feeding procedure. When we are caring for a patient with a stroke who is fed with an NG tube due to dysphagia, we should be aware about how to perform NG feeding in a correct way. First of all, we should identify the patient. Then we have to prepare the patient's surrounding for the procedure. Positioning and area preparation. Patient's position should be 30 degrees to 45 degrees. Semi-Fowler's position. Next, we should wash hands and gather equipment for feeding and checking the placement of the tube. These are face towels, 50 ml syringe, 2 measuring cups for water and formula, stethoscope, pH strip. Checking the NG tube in placement is most important before each feeding. Normally, we can use an auscultation of bowel sounds by using a stethoscope. In this method, take the 50 ml syringe and draw 20 ml of air and then attach the syringe into a feeding port of the tube. Place the stethoscope in epigastric region and check the bowel sounds while flushing air through NG tube. Just after auscultation, we should withdraw air that was flushed in. We have an alternative method to check the placement of the tube using pH strips. Here, we should aspirate gastric content and check the pH value. The pH should be less than 5.5. We should clamp the NG tube to prevent air entering and then attach the syringe to the feeding port. Flush 20 ml of water through the syringe and unclamp the tube while flushing. Position the syringe slightly above the head. Ensure the syringe is not empty during feeding. That is to prevent and minimize stomach discomfort due to excessive air entry. Continue feeding after flushing 20 ml of water. During the feeding, we should be aware of clamping and unclamping the tube. We can give 250 ml at a time, water and formula, or prescribed amount. After the feeding, the tube should be flushed with 20 ml of water. Then, the feeding port needs to be closed with a stopper. Wash hands and then documentation needs to be done.